Good morning. May I warmly welcome you in the name of the Lord Jesus to our service today, to our KidZone Christmas tree service. And we pray that we would know the Spirit of the Lord Jesus with us as we celebrate and remember his birth, he who came as Emmanuel, God with us. Just as we begin the service, can I say a massive thank you to Karen and Jim, and to all their helpers, and to all of you at the front, to KidZone, for all your hard work and for all your practice. And we're really, really looking forward to the service today and all the things that you're going to share with us. And you all look great, and you all look amazing, and it's wonderful that we're here for this time of celebration and worship. I'd just like to make some announcements. And just to remind you, on the back of the news sheet of the COVID guidelines and restrictions, and ask you to continually read them and remind yourself of them. The rest of the announcements are in the sheet. I'd like to say a big thank you to all of you who have brought gifts to be placed under the Christmas tree. As in the news sheet there, you'll see that it says that those gifts can be left at the start of the service or as you leave. However, there will be a little time later on in the service that if there is anyone in the church that has a present and would like to bring it up, there will be a wee moment where you can do that, and I'll explain that when we get there. Throughout the Christmas season, you have the opportunity to give by using the Christmas offering envelopes, both for World Development and for Craig at Christmas offerings. Hopefully next week at our service, we'll spend a little bit of time talking about World Development Appeal and watching a little video to explain to us about the work of that appeal. I would encourage you to give generously to those offerings throughout this festive season. You're invited after the service today to the coffee bar in the Allen Hall for a time of fellowship and refreshment. And please, if you can't stay for that, just remember to continue to wear your mask as you move around the hall and to only eat and drink while seated. The Zoom Bible study will continue tomorrow night at 7 p.m. and all are very welcome to that. Morning Watch will meet on Tuesday at 10:45 in the session room. The Evergreens meet on Wednesday at 12 noon in the Barber Hall for their Christmas lunch. The walking group will walk on Saturday, meeting at 10 a.m. at Kern Wood. And if you would like to come along to that, if you'd please speak to Robert McNair. The only other announcement is just to, announce that next Lord's Day at 11 a.m. we'll have our youth Bible class service, a super Christmas, and all are very welcome to that. And this evening and next Lord's Day evening, we'll have our services of carols by candlelight, the same service repeated. So please make sure to register for one or the other. So they are all our announcements. And as we come to worship today, boys and girls, and big boys and girls too, we've been lighting this candle the last couple of Sundays, haven't we? So here we have our Advent wreath with our beautiful candles on it, and with our four candles. Can anybody remember what the first candle was? Just shout out if you remember. Hope. Remember, in a world that seems dark and hopeless, in a world where everything seems like it's all falling apart, we don't know where to turn, Jesus comes and shows us the nature of God and shows us that we can put our hope in him, because he is the only one who can show us the true nature of God. And then what do we have after that? What was it? Love. Well done, it was love. Because what we saw in Jesus was the fact that he came to show us that God loved us enough that he would give us his only son to die on the cross for our sins. Because that's what Jesus means. Jesus came, and one of the things that his name means is it is he who came to save us from our sins. And sin is everything that we think, say, and do that breaks God's laws. And Jesus came to show us the love of God to save us from that. So, what is next? Go ahead. What is it? Joy. So, when we light this, we light the candle of joy. Now, joy and happiness are not the same thing. Because happiness sometimes
comes and goes. Sometimes being happy has as much to do with how much chocolate you've eaten and how much sleep you've had as it is to do with anything else. But joy is not that. Joy is the sense in our hearts that God is always with us, even when we're up and when we're down, or when we're somewhere in between. Joy is the knowledge that God is with us, and that's what Jesus came to bring. So next week, what will we light?
Peace.
And then on Christmas morning, we light the middle candle and remember that Jesus was born. We don't know when Jesus was born. We don't know if it was on the 25th of December. But we use the 25th of December as a day to celebrate the fact that Jesus was born into the world. So we will pray. We will say a wee prayer. Let's pray. Father, we thank and praise you for your Son, the Lord Jesus. We thank you that he came to give us hope. He came to show us love. And he came to give us joy. A sense of knowing that you are with us always, when we're sad, when we're happy, or when we're somewhere in between. So we thank you that when we put our trust in Jesus, when we put our faith in him, we can know that he is with us at all times, and that can give us a great and deep joy. We pray in his name. Amen. So we're going to stand and sing together, and we're going to do so with the words of 314. Come and join the celebration. As we unite our hearts to pray together, I'm delighted to invite Sarah, who's going to come up and to lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Loving God, with Mary and Joseph gazing into the manger, with shepherds hurrying to the stable, with angels praising you on high, with wise men kneeling before the Christ child, we also gather to marvel and celebrate the birth of Jesus, offering you our heartfelt worship and joyful praise. May what was news of great joy for them bring joy likewise to us this day and very day. May we experience the warmth of your love and the blessing of your presence, so that you receive the worship that is rightly yours. Hear us as we join in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Hiya, boys and girls. Remember me? I'm Lucy. It's great to be back here again in Craigha. Now, where's that silly friend of mine, Bert? Have any of you seen him? Bert, come out wherever you are.
Coming. Oh, hello everyone. Hey, Lucy, it's been ages and ages since we've been here.
I know. And who'd have thought that almost 2 years on, we'd still be talking about this coronavirus thingy?
It's like a bad smell. It just won't go away.
Are you calling me a bad smell?
No.
I'm just fed up with all this, the PCR tests.
Look at the positive side of things. With all these lockdowns and self-isolating, you've got to see more of your close family. Why I need to talk to you now is because I've just received the cast list for our school nativity play, and I'm sure you want to know what part you've got.
Yes, please. But first, let me guess. Am I Joseph?
No. That went to class what, as always.
Yeah, I thought so. But first, am I the innkeeper then?
No. With the confusion in the hospitality industry at the moment over the COVID passports, they did away with that part that year.
Well, am I a shepherd?
No.
They're out too, as they were told to work from home.
Well, am I a wise man?
But I think with the word wise in there, you've already answered that question. That would be a step too far, even for casting you in that part.
Well, what's left? I'm sure I'm no angel.
You said it. And anyway, I've got that part.
Surprise, surprise. I'm not the donkey again, am I?
No, but you did such a good job of that last year, it seemed to suit your personality.
Well, what then? Who's left?
Well, you've actually been cast this year as the sheep.
A sheep? Sure, they're not important to the Christmas story. I'd be better off cast as a tree.
But the sheep were really important.
I don't believe you.
Yes, they were. And I can tell you some stories over the next wee while to show you just how important they were.
Well, okay. I'm prepared to give it a go. I think I need to try some method acting techniques to get me in the right frame of mind for being a sheep.
Well, you do whatever you need to do. Just keep thinking sheep and I'm sure you'll be great. I could get some of the other animals in the manger to come along and help you get into your new role as a sheep.
Maybe a song would help.
Good idea. I'll get them ready to sing a song with you. But while we're waiting, Emily McCormick is going to come up and read us the first part of the Christmas story.
Okay, I'll be back soon. Or as the old saying goes, as quick as the shake of a lamb's tail. Bye!
Bye!
The birth of Jesus. At the time, the Emperor Augustus ordered a census to be taken throughout the Roman Empire. When this first census took place, Quirinius was the governor of Syria. Everyone then went to register himself, each to his own town. Joseph went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to the town of Bethlehem in Judea. the birthplace of King David. Joseph went there because he was a descendant of David. He went to register with Mary, who was promised in marriage to him. She was pregnant, and while they were in Bethlehem, the time came for her to have her baby. She gave birth to her first son, wrapped him in strips of cloth, and laid him in a manger. There was no room for them to stay in the inn. Thanks be to God.
I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. Don't wanna be a goat, no. Don't wanna be a goat, no. They haven't got any hope, no. Don't wanna be a goat, no. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I don't wanna be a hypocrite. Don't wanna be a hypocrite. They're not hip to it. Don't wanna be a hypocrite. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba.
I wanna be a sheep.
Really wanna be. Really wanna be a sheep, Lord. I don't wanna be a Sadducee. Cause they're so Sadducee. I don't wanna be a Sadducee. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a child of God. I just wanna be a child of God. Walking the same path he trod. I just wanna be a child of God. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I pray the Lord my soul to keep. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I really wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I really wanna be, ba 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 ba. Wanna be a sheep, ba 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 ba. I just wanna be a sheep, yeah. I really wanna be a sheep.
Well, sticking with our theme of wanting to be a sheep, we're going to sing the next hymn, number 340, While Shepherds Watch Their Flocks by Night.
Thank you.
We're now going to hear another reading from the Bible, but this time we're going to hear and see it on the screen.
A song for the shepherds.
The shepherds were out in the field watching their sheep.
Outside in the middle of the night.
They were sitting around the campfire trying to keep warm.
It was so dark.
Suddenly, there was a bright light.
It was this bright.
It was so bright, like, I couldn't even see the light.
They were really scared. The angel said unto them, "Fear not.
Fear not. I bring you good tidings of great joy. It shall be to all people.
Do not be afraid. Today in the city of David, a Savior is born for you.
You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger."
Suddenly there are so many angels.
1 trillion. Or a billion, I think.
Or, oh, I know, a thousands of angels.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
5 angels come.
Tons of angels.
Millions of them.
They had wings and like this, and then they have bright lights, like how bright that light is.
They look at the light.
Big soldiers with flaming swords.
They were singing, "Glory to God!
Glory to God in the highest!
Glory to God in the highest! Peace, goodwill towards men!
Peace on earth, goodwill to men."
The shepherd said, "Let's go to Bethlehem."
"Come, let us go."
They ran so fast down the hill.
They passed all the inns that didn't have any room.
They made their way to the dirty stable.
The shepherds were so happy when they woke that baby Jesus.
And the shepherds went and knocked on everybody's door and said, "Haven't you heard? Jesus is born. Savior Christ is born."
The end.
I'm very cracked today. Good morning. Well, that's a wee bit better. Now, I take it you've gathered the theme of today's service. Could be sheep, okay? And what we're going to do now, we've got some of our youngest members of KidZone are going to come up and sing a song. Now, what song do you think of? What nursery rhyme do you think of when you think of sheep? Any nursery rhyme yet? Ba, ba, black sheep. Well, that's the tune of our song today, but it's to different words. So do you think our 5 wee sheep could come up? I see we've one objecting to his costume already. It's going to go well. Okay, where's my sheep? Harry, you put your hood up. Okay, who else have we got? Let's see. Okay. And the naked sheep, as we call them. Okay, can we all squish up a wee bit? Okay, now we're going to sing up our song. Now I think the words might come up on the screen as well if you all want to sing along with it, because you'll know the tune anyway. And I might run the mic along a wee bit, because some have been practicing very, very hard and want to hear. Okay?
Born in a stable a long way away, a tiny little baby in a bed of hay. His mother was Mary, and the angels did sing, "Glory to God for the birth of the King." Born in the stable a long way away, a tiny little baby in a bed of hay.
Well done. Okay. You want to do... Well done for managing to keep your costumes on for that amount of time. Okay. Okay. Now, okay, Oliver, do you want to go and sit down now? Now, if you remember in the Bible, Jesus used to tell stories all the time called parables, and he told stories, and we did one in KidZone recently called The Lost Sheep. Do you remember that? About how the shepherd was so worried and so happy when he found the sheep again, a bit like when God is happy when we come back to him. So stories are good, and they're a good way of telling you things. So they are. And when I was a wee girl, we had a program on the television, and it may still be on in some channels somewhere because so much. And it was called Jack and Nori. Anybody remember that? Jack and Nori, where somebody came and would tell you a story. And sometimes it was a famous person, sometimes it was an actor, actress, whatever, sometimes just an ordinary person. So I thought, well, let somebody tell a story today. So I'm going to ask the Reverend Mackenzie to come. Now, he needs the big chair, don't you, to sit in? The big chair to come and tell you this story today. There you go, leave it. So listen carefully.
Are you sitting comfortably? Let us begin. Once upon a time, in a sunny valley, there lived a little lamb called Joshua. He was white with black spots, black feet, and sad eyes. Josh felt sad when he saw the other lambs with snow white wool and no spots. He felt sad when he saw the other sheep with their moms and dads because he didn't have a mom or dad. But he felt saddest when he saw the other lambs running and jumping because he couldn't. Josh had been born with one leg that didn't work properly. He was crippled. He always limped when he walked. That's why he always watched while the other lambs ran and played. Josh felt sad and alone, except when Abigail was around. Abigail was Josh's best friend. She didn't look like a friend for a lamb. She was an old cow. She was brown, with white blotches that looked like rain puddles on a path. Her belly was as round as a barrel, and her voice was always kind and friendly. Some of Josh's favourite hours were spent with Abigail. They loved to pretend that they were on adventures in a distant land. Josh liked to listen to Abigail tell stories about the stars. They would spend hours on the hill looking into the valley. They were good friends. But even with a friend like Abigail, Josh still got sad. It made him sad to be the only lamb who could not run and jump and play in the grass. That's when Abigail would turn to him and say, "Don't be sad, little Joshua. God has a special place for those who feel left out." Josh wanted to believe her, but it was hard. Some days he just felt alone. He really felt alone the day the shepherds decided to take the lambs to the next valley where there was more grass. The sheep had been in this valley so long that the ground was nearly bare. All the sheep were excited when the shepherd told them they were going to a new meadow. As they prepared to leave, Josh hobbled over and took his place on the edge of the group. But the others started laughing at him. "You're too slow to go all the way to the next valley. Go back, Joshua. We'll never get there if we have to wait for you." That's when Joshua looked up and saw the shepherds standing in front of him. "They are right," my little Joshua, you better go back. This trip is too long for you. Go and spend the night in the stable. Josh looked at the man for a long time. Then he turned slowly and began limping away. When Josh got to the top of the hill, he looked down and saw all the other sheep headed towards the green grass. Never before had he felt so left out. A big tear slipped out of his eye, rolled down his nose, and fell on a rock. Just then he heard Abigail behind him, and Abigail said what she always said when Joshua felt sad. Don't be sad, little Joshua. God has a special place for those who feel left out. Slowly, the two friends turned and walked to the stable together. By the time they got to the little barn, the sun was setting like a big orange ball. Josh and Abigail went inside and began to eat some hay out of the feed box. They were very hungry, and the hay tasted good. For a little while, Joshua forgot he had been left behind. Go to sleep, little friend, Abigail said after they had finished eating. You have had a hard day. Josh was tired, so he lay down in the corner on some straw and closed his eyes. He felt Abigail lie down beside him, and he was glad to have Abigail as a friend. Soon Josh was asleep. At first he slept soundly, curled up against Abigail's back. In his sleep he dreamed. He dreamed of running and jumping just like the other sheep. He dreamed of long walks with Abigail through the valley. He dreamed of being in a place where he was never left out. But suddenly, strange noises woke him. Abigail, he whispered, wake up. I'm scared. Abigail lifted her big head and looked around. The stable was dark, except for a small lamp hanging in the wall. Somebody is in here, Josh whispered. They looked across the dimly lighted stable, and there, lying on some fresh hay in the feed box, was a baby. A young woman was resting on a big pile of hay beside the feed box. Josh looked at Abigail, thinking his friend could tell him what was going on. But Abigail was just as surprised as Josh. Josh looked again at the woman and the child, then limped across the stable. He stopped next to the mother and looked into the baby's face. The baby was crying. He was cold. The woman picked up the baby and put him on the hay next to her. Josh looked around the stable for something to keep the baby warm. Usually there were blankets, but not tonight. The shepherds had taken them on their trip across the valley. Just then, Joshua remembered his own soft, warm wool. He walked over and curled up close to the baby. Thank you, little lamb, the baby's mother said softly. Soon the little child stopped crying and went back to sleep. About that time, a man entered the stable carrying some rags. I'm sorry, Mary, he explained. This is all the cover I could find. It's okay, she explained. This little lamb has kept the new king warm. A king? Joshua looked at the baby and wondered who he might be. His name is Jesus. Mary spoke as if she knew Joshua's question. God's son, he came from heaven to teach us about God. Just then, another noise at the door. It was the shepherds, the ones who had left Joshua behind. Their eyes were big and they were excited. We saw a bright light and we heard the angels, they began. And then they saw Joshua next to the baby. Joshua, do you know who this baby is? He does now. It was the young mother who was speaking. She looked at Joshua and smiled. God has heard your prayers, little lamb. This baby is the answer. Joshua looked down at the baby. Somehow he knew this was a special child and a special moment. He also understood why he had been born with a crippled leg. Had he been like the other sheep, he wouldn't have been in the valley. But since he was different, he was in the stable among the first to welcome Jesus into the world. He turned and he walked back to Abigail and took his place beside his friend. "You were right," he told her. "God does have a special place for me." We're going to pray once again, and this time I'm delighted to ask Ben to come, and he's going to help us to think about others and to pray for the Lord.
Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for the good things that we have to enjoy this Christmas. In thanking you, Lord, we also pause to pray for those who will go hungry this Christmas, for those who will live in parts of the world that have undergone terrible tragedies leading to outbreaks of famine and disease. We pray for those lives torn apart by war, for those lives have been devastated by natural disasters such as earthquakes, wildfires and volcanoes, for those around the world and in our own country that have been affected by the COVID pandemic. Let them know that we have not forgotten about them. We pray that you will guide the actions of the world leaders in these uncertain times so that the peace and harmony can be restored around the world. We pray for the leaders in our country too, that they can find a path where they can work together for the good of everyone. Help us to restore and clean up those areas that have been affected by tragedy, and remember that it is only your love that can help us clean up what we feel in our hearts. Jesus was sent to earth at Christmas out of love. Help us to show this love to those around the world and around us, to wash away the sin that makes us do the wrong things. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Right, we're going to do our second song soon, but first I want to talk to you a wee minute. I'm just moving the chair out of the way, give a wee bit of space. Okay. Now, do any of you ever go out at Christmas to places like the Opera House or the Waterfront of the Lyric or anything like that? Do you ever go to see what's on there now? No, nobody know, any of the adults? Cinderella. What's Cinderella? Is it the pantomime? None of you ever go and see a pantomime? You see, you have. You just say, well, we used to do a pantomime here in Craiga, as many people know, before we all got really old and tired. And then I'm thinking back when I did one of my first pantomimes over 40 years ago. Okay? It's a long, long while away. None of you were born 40 years ago. So you weren't. A lot of congregation weren't born 40 years ago. Our minister wasn't even born 40 years ago when I was on the stage singing. Now, and we're going to do a song, my first song that I ever did in pantomime. And I'll give you a wee bit of a clue. I have to get my props here, Kim. Hey, Tim, what's that? A bucket. Buckets are great, aren't they? You can carry water in the buckets, you can carry your soil around the garden, but all sorts of things in the bucket. So this is a great bucket. Is there anything wrong with it? What, there's a hole in my bucket? Do you know, that sounds like a song I used to sing in the pantomime many, many years ago. And that's the song, it was called There's a Hole in My Bucket. But I didn't sing it a moan. It was a duet, because you have to sing it to someone and they sing it back to you. Who do you think I might have sung it with way back in the time? Anybody else? No, I didn't even know Jim 40 years ago. So it was not Jim. Any other takers? No. Who? Anyone here? Yeah. You're not allowed to answer. Dennison? No. Do you know Dennison wasn't even in the pantomime 40 years ago? He's a novice. He's only been did it for about 35 or so. Anyone else? Well, I did this with the person who at the time was the dame. That's the person that dresses up the funny part. But he then turned into a baddie. And he was a baddie for many, many years in the pantomime. Anybody know who I mean now? Nigel Platt, that's right. Nigel sung this with me over 40 years ago. But today I'm going to use KidZone instead. I won't use Nigel. And we're not going to sing about buckets, here or not. We're going to sing about sheep. So I'm going to put my bucket down a wee minute. And I'm going to use KidZone to help me sing this song. So I first of all need, where's my shepherds? I have a bunch of shepherds, don't I? Okay, so if my shepherds want to come and stand over, move forward a wee bit there, just out of the way of the manger. Okay, so Ben, over here, over, come on, over this way, go practice. Here. Keep over this way, because there's a whole lot of you, there's some stand down here. Okay, James down here, okay. And my angels, where's my angels? Over the far side, over here. You come over here, this side. No. Okay. You bunch up a wee bit, you come in here. Okay. Lovely. Okay. Hope you're getting this down. Okay. And poor baby Jesus looks like he needs nursed a wee bit, doesn't he? So I think he needs his mother, Mary. Okay, Mary. Okay. Now, Jim, I'm going to have to put you in charge of the shepherds. Is that okay?
Well, I don't really feel like a shepherd. Let's see. I better go and get something. Hang on.
Right, hold on. He's going to be in charge of you lot. That's... What's he getting?
There, okay, that's better now. I feel like a shepherd.
Feel a bit more shepherd. Well, you stand down there. Don't set yourself on fire beside the advent calendars, if that's okay. Okay. Right, now, are we ready? I believe, shepherds, you've had a few problems with your sheep at the minute. You can maybe tell us about it in the song. Would that be okay? Ready to sing up? Okay, Dorothy.
There's a sheep gone, I'm missing, I'm missing, I'm missing. There's a sheep gone, I'm missing, dear Karen, a sheep.
Then find it, dear shepherds, dear shepherds.
Dear shepherds, then find it, dear shepherds, find it.
But it's night time, dear Karen, dear Karen, dear Karen. But it's night time, dear Karen. We're afraid of the dark.
There's a light shining brightly, dear shepherds, dear shepherds. There's a light shining brightly. It's dazzling us all.
What is it, dear Karen, dear Karen, dear Karen? What is it, dear Karen? We're really quite scared.
Why, it's angels, dear shepherds, dear shepherds, dear shepherds. Why, it's angels, dear shepherds, with a message from God. Now listen, dear shepherds, dear shepherd, dear shepherds. Now listen, dear shepherd, to a message from God. There's a baby, dear shepherds, dear shepherds, dear shepherds. There's a baby, dear shepherds, the true son of God. And where shall we find him?
Angels, angels, and where shall we find him? This true son of God.
He lies in a stable. Shepherds, dear shepherds.
So off went those shepherds, those shepherds, those shepherds. So off went those shepherds, they've run to the town.
In a stable was Jesus, was Jesus, was Jesus. In a stable was Jesus, the dear Son of God.
The shepherds now worship, now worship, now worship. The shepherds now worship the dear Son of God.
Now
What else did they find there, dear Karen, dear Karen? What else did they find there in that place long ago?
Why, it's the... It's the sheep that went a-missing, a-missing, a-missing. The sheep that went a-missing, asleep on the hay. Well done, is that okay? Wait, stay. Now, if I want you all to stay up here, if you all stay up there one wee minute. Okay, you can move over there. Don't have any. Now, while we're all here, we're all going to sing together the carol, Away in a Manger, number 309. Okay?
Friends, it said on the news sheet this morning that you could bring your Christmas presents up at the start of the service or at the end of the service, but if anybody would like to bring up their present at this point, you're welcome to do so. And I see the kids are doing that now, which is great. So if there are any wee presents you would like to bring up, you can please feel free to do that now. Thank you so much. And as I said at the outset of the service, I do want to express once again thanks to you all for supporting this appeal for presents as they go to support the work of the Belfast Central Mission and the Prisoners Fellowship. And we know that these gifts will be very much appreciated by those who receive them at this time of the year. As we approach the end of our time together this morning, we're going to have a poem, and Caitlin's going to come and to read to us The Lamb by William Blake.
Thank you. Little Lamb by William Blake. Little Lamb, who made thee? Dost thou know who made thee? Give thee life and bid thee feed by the stream and o'er the mead. Give thee clothing of delight, soft as clothing, woolly bright. Give thee such a tender voice, making all the vales rejoice. Little Lamb, who made thee? Dost thou know who made thee? Little Lamb, I'll tell thee. Little Lamb, I'll tell thee. He is called by thy name, for he calls himself a lamb. He is meek and he is mild. He became a little child. I a child and thou a lamb. We are called by his name. Little Lamb, God bless thee. Little Lamb, God bless thee.
Hope you've enjoyed some of our sheep stories today.
Yeah, you know, Lucy, you were right. I never realized how important the sheep were to the Christmas story until I heard all about the little lamb.
No matter how small or unimportant we feel, God can have a special role for us to play.
Yeah, I must remember that as I perform my very special role as a sheep in our school play.
I think we should finish off by singing a song to celebrate all things sheepish.
All things sheepish? That'll be interesting.
Yes, feel free to dance or join in or sing whatever you want.
Oh, Lucy, I forgot to give you a message. Mum says you're welcome to come over on Boxing Day to have tea with us.
That's very kind of you. I'd love to.
Don't get too excited. We usually have leftover Christmas dinner heated up.
That's okay. I love Christmas dinner, especially the turkey.
Well, I'm afraid Mum's gone all experimental this year and has decided to try something different and not have turkey.
What, you mean chicken or something like that?
Nope.
What then? Roast beef?
Nope, not that either.
What about fish then?
No, still wrong.
Well, what then?
Lamb.
Ah, no, but not lamb. I could never eat that.
Okay.
Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. 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 He's got a flock of lambs who know him. Robbers can't steal him from his hand. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Went through the fence looking for some friends. God saw me scram, so he brought me back again. Cause I'm alive, ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. You got to follow where he's going. God will take you in the promised land. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. He's got a flock of lambs who know him. Robbers can't steal him from his hand. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs.
Scratch it, Carl, scratch it.
Tried many moves, tried getting loose, tried petting zoos, but I knew they wouldn't do. Cause I'm a lamb, ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. You gotta follow where he's going. God'll take you in the promised land. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs.
Ba 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 ba, we're lambs.
Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. He's got a flock of lambs who know him. Robbers can't steal him from his hand. Ba 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 ba, we're lambs. Ba, we're lambs. Ba, we're lambs.
Let's pray. Father, we thank and praise you so very much that you sent your Son to remind us of how much you love us and how much we mean to you. We thank you that by calling upon his name, by trusting in him, we can all find our place in the kingdom that you're building, where we are all valued and loved together as we seek to see you glorified across the road and around the world. Help us this Christmas season to remember afresh that Lord, that baby who came, who grew to go to the cross and die and rise again to be the Saviour of the world. We thank you that he did indeed come as good news and as a light in the darkness. He came as Emmanuel, God with us. By the power of his Spirit, we ask that you would unite us together so that we can celebrate as those who know this Jesus, in whose name we pray. Amen. So we're going to sing just to bring our service to its conclusion. And once again, can I just say thank you so much to all of you and to Jim and Karen and to all the folks behind the scenes for putting this service together. It has really been a wonderful occasion and you've done all so very well. And again, we want to thank you for that. But let's stand and sing number 334, See Him Lying on a Bed of Straw. And now may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God our Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be ours and ours to share this day, and indeed forevermore. Amen.